when Ray passed away, he made the decision to empower his family and charge them with advancing his legacy through the Ray C. Anderson Foundation. And I want to recognize that family. Here in the front, we have Ray's two daughters, Mary Ann Lanier, my mother, and my aunt Harriet Langford, along with their husbands, Jamie Lanier and Phil Langford. These are the four trustees of this foundation who set its leadership. As a fam- As a family, we knew that to advance Ray's legacy, we were going to need the right partners to help us build upon the ideas that Ray believed in most strongly. And as you heard from him in that video, biomimicry is one of those ideas. He knew it was so right, so smart. And so it has been our distinct privilege to partner with the Biomimicry Institute, their executive director, Beth Ratner, and with Janine. We chose to invest in this design challenge. And as you heard from Janine, to add to it, to allow for the creation of an accelerator round. Because we believe that the ideas that young innovators come up with, ideas that are truly inspired by nature, they need to come to life. It has been our privilege to be a part of this journey. And we knew that at the end of the road for these teams, and honestly, this is not the end of the road. This is a marking point. We wanted to mark, though, a moment that would be deserving of Ray's name. And so we have created this grand prize, the Ray C. Anderson Ray of Hope Prize, with a $100,000 commitment to the winning team, because we want it to be something that keeps Ray's name, his vision, alive for all of us. The teams that have advanced to this finalist stage, to this accelerator round, are truly global. And that is one of the aspects of this that excites me the most. From Slovakia, the team that created the biocultivator is trying to connect people in urban spaces with growing their own food. From Chile, Bionurse and their biopatch trying to restore soil. You look to Italy, and Hexagrow is trying to come up with new and innovative ways through an aeroponic food production system to change the way that people connect to their food. From Thailand, Jube has found a way to enhance local poor people's ability to go and find the insects that they rely upon for their protein sources. You look here in the United States from Oregon, the living filtration system, which is tackling the problem of eutrophication from excess fertilizer runoff. And then you look back to Italy and the mangrove still team trying to find a way to use salt water to rehabilitate dry lands and make them fit for agriculture. And then finally in El Salvador, Oasis Aquaponics is trying to bring ruthlessly affordable aquaponic systems to people who need them most. It truly is a global design challenge, and I know that Ray would be proud of that. And so now I would like to invite Megan Schuknecht, Director of Design Challenges for the Biomimicry Institute, to join me on stage, as well as Janine and all seven teams that have been competing for this Ray of Hope Prize. Thank you, thank you. Bioneers family, that was just breathtaking. Thank you, they deserve this. And I have to say that this is the right place for this award to be given. Our heartfelt thanks from the family of Ray Anderson goes to Kenny and Nina and to Joshua for allowing Bioneers to be the place where we give the very first Ray of Hope Prize. So thank you to Bioneers. This past Thursday, each of these seven teams sat before a panel of seven judges, and we spent a significant amount of time hearing their pitches, why they deserve to be the first Ray of Hope Prize winner. We looked at their financials and presentations. We did a deep dive into their prototypes, which you can see in the Biomimicry Institute's booth outside of the theater. I encourage you to stop by and see what they've built. We had, as judges, a very difficult task, choosing the one team that should win this award. And I believe I can speak on behalf of all of those judges in saying that they are all deserving, and they will all move forward from this point committed to making their dreams a reality. But in choosing that one winner, we knew that we had to find the team that had best balanced a true commitment to the practice of biomimicry in their design with a team that has found a way to prove the viability of their idea, believing that it will go forward from this point and become a reality. Finally, balanced with the impact that they will make on the challenges that we have in our food systems. And after balancing all of those, judging these teams against that standard, we were able to choose the very first Ray C. Anderson Ray of Hope Prize winner to receive $100,000 from our foundation. The very first award winner from Chile is Bionurse. Truly, a congratulation is owed to all of these teams, and they will all be moving forward. These ideas are all phenomenal. I would encourage all of you to stay tuned, to follow the Biomimicry Institute, and as you heard, a new challenge is open. It is a 2-year process to go from initial concept and dream to this moment on this stage. And I believe that the next challenge being focused on climate change will yield more amazing innovations. Thank you all so much.